need to rely on the Lantern. They want that AoE CC.
Definitely attested support for Bubba Dub. One against Cloud9 in week 6 with that Sona pickup, along with Rush for Sork Boots coming out from Prowler.
That was such a high value award there for TSM. And a great job by them jumping on the opportunity to steal that gold lead back.
So much dodging being done in the middle lane.
That's what this this lane here is all about, dodging skill shots. Once again, everybody's super long range. Okay, now they go for the dive.
Got him.
Oh, flash still not up.
Just at 11 minutes. Look how much time he has in the flash. Woo. That timing.
Yeah, they barely got back there.
Complexity putting a lot of focus on actually Westrice being in that top lane with the current wards they place for him. So for him to teleport out there, a little bit of a waste on that, but they're still there for use. Coming up on 15 minutes, still the only kill to Complexity. How will they push this snowball, though? It's a very small one. Usually we see them get a triple kill or a very big lead. Are they going to be able to work this small incrementally?
Well, it's going to be the bottom lane here. Focus from both junglers. They do have pink wards pretty much throughout the river here. Very good coverage from
Gleep. Bye-bye. Gleep gets popped right there. Bubba Dub comes up with a kill for himself. Not where they really want it to go, but it works.
That ward coverage paying off because of the recent base by Bjergsen, another tower for Complexity.
And it's gonna be hard. They don't exactly have a siege controlling team on the side of TSM unless Bjergsen is really putting out a blue. Wild Turtle's gonna wanna be farming. And even if they try to engage, you gotta remember Bubba Dub has that exhaust for Dyrus or Amazing if they try to make a play. It's gonna shut down a lot of damage that TSM thinks they have in the fight.
Woo!
Just on the tail.
You don't even wanna go that way, Westrice. What do you do? There's no benefit for him to go that way.
Under the turret! Stun him! Stun him! Cannot. He gets stunned himself. This is no! How does this happen? TSM just sent Complexity into a frenzy. They did 5 games before they played this one, so they're ready. They're ready to go for the long haul.
Now, it's interesting that since they're kind of sensing this game going so long, Prowly's gone with the Deathfire Grasp. Because there are so few picks right now, he really wants to be able to capitalize on any pick that they do get.
Yeah.
So if they find one person, Prowly's going to make sure that he can kill that one person.
Ooh.
Well, he's the one who gets found, though.
Oh!
Bjergsen got it!
He finds it! Bullseye on to Prowly. The shot comes out. He didn't get the explosive on him, just the buster. There's not going to be the burn. A long range Peacemaker puts him in the box. It's going to be Westrice thinking he can in the fight now. A few more shots, amazing ward jumps, but is he going to be able to finalize? The Sonic Wave does not hit, but he's in position. Westrice gets the heal from Bubba Dub, but goes down to the end of Wild Turtle, who starts picking himself up some kills.
Baron is really their focus. They already have the wards down on blue side, and since they have position on Baron, they can just huddle around the pinks. They're trying to bait. Scrying Orb, very long cooldowns, is not upgraded for Robert yet. So that won't be available, and they kind of corner themselves up against this mid turret.
Oh my god, Prowly hurt. TSM sensing blood in the water, and they go straight for him. It's going to be back onto Amazing, though. So much chaos as TSM surrounds the fight. All of Complexity is partying in the middle, and TSM cannot find the right focus. Westrice and the rest of the team focus down onto one. Cleave goes down, and TSM thought they had. Great use of the composition from Team Solo Mid, not pushing any farther than they need to in the fight. Westrice wants to get a piece, though. Dyrus jumps in, but he goes right out, trying to bait in more attacks on himself, on that crowd control tank that he can break easily amongst more people on the other team. And it looks like they played that one very nicely. They have summoners out across the board. The exhaust is now down, really the only thing shutting down. The other strides of power of Team Solo Mid. There's one kill coming in. Prowly goes down. That was really the impact, shock and awe damage they were looking to get out of the fight. Robert X. Lee was the next one, and he goes down. The DPS is down and out. There goes the support. The tank is going to be the next to follow. Perfect focus from Team Solo Mid on the entry fight, and now they're on the Nexus turrets.
Hear the crowd. TSM did indeed one.
They did indeed one. 49 minutes on this one. 9-3. Bjergsen going gold on the Nexus as they take down Complexity.